Howdy-doody, everybody.
Let's get the face in the screen. Two faces. Surprise! Three faces, counting him. Four, counting him.
Okay, yeah. All true.
So, we're doing another glitch twitch.
I see we have our fans O3Z with us. And Blue Dahlia, that was with us last stream also. And, of course, our everlasting fan, Gooball.
Hi, Gooball.
Welcome, Gooball.
Did you enjoy the wasp modeling texturing?
Oh, Claire Dead is here as well.
Hi, Claire Dead.
And Blue Dahlia asks, why do you guys not stream in the creative section?
Oh, because we didn't know there was a creative section. We're quite new to Twitch. And we just knew that we needed a Twitch account.
Yeah, we made a Twitch account and we threw our two heads on and we started talking. And yeah, we have done, I think, 4 or 5 streams now?
More.
More?
Counting every stream, I think it's around 9.
9 streams
but
already?
Some only 10 seconds and some only 4 minutes.
That testing streams don't count, Vincent.
And then we learned from a professional that we at least should do at least an hour stream because people come in during the stream. So if you only do 10 minute streams, they will just not be too late.
Yeah.
And then, something's happening. Oh. You hear that? I think we're being attacked by robots.
There's a robot mosquito here out for our blood. But anyway, yeah, so there's a creative section.
So we'll check that out and we'll see if we can transfer it to that area.
We'll Google it. Google always knows.
And Google? Did he ask?
Google says, yes, it was very fun to watch. That's good.
I will show you what I did a stream during the day, just modeling some robot insect, and it turned out quite well. I will show you the end result.
Oh, the end result is very cool. It's all very work in progress, of course, but in a few days' work, I think Vincent did awesome. I think you really did well on this one.
This is a wasp. It's quite big, actually. A normal wasp would be yay big. This wasp would be yay big.
Very big.
And he can fly.
Oh, hi, Jordy. And hi, Lotje. Welcome to our stream.
And he can attack. Hi, Lotje. It's also a very, how do you call it?
A fan.
Yeah. Continuous presence in our
yes, for which I am very grateful, dear. Claire Dead says he's very happy how you can tell that it's not a bee or a fat lobster.
It's a wasp, right? From each angle it looks like a wasp, I think.
Yeah, I think it does. I think it reads well. I think the paws are really cool.
This is of course in a 3D studio, so this is black and white or gray. Just gray.
Yeah, it isn't textured at the moment.
But today we're going to work on the jungle, and inside the jungle there will be wasps. And if you can see this image, this is a concept art we made of the thing that happens after you play the demo, because we already told this in an update that Something happens. You get caught by the spider.
Yeah.
And after that, what happens when you get caught by the spider? Well, we can tell you that Glitch is alone because he got away.
But because for some reason
They're only interested
in Stuffy.
And not in Glitch. So yeah. The spider ignores Glitch and grabs Stuffy and takes him away with his robot friends. And Glitch spotted them on the bridge in the jungle. So this will be part of the game, and we'll be working on this scene. So I will be working on making this 3D in Unity. I will show you the.
So I'm working, and Vincent's going to work from scratch. So in the beginning, there's nothing.
There's this.
There's just empty space all around. A gray rock. There's a basic texture on there.
A little bit bumpiness, but that's just to give it an idea that there's a border here. Here's absolutely nothing. Endless space. As you can see, we're making a world as we go. This is the whole world. Last thing we made was the beach, which we'll be showing today as an update.
No, not today. So tomorrow.
Not today, right? Oh, tomorrow. Okay.
Yeah. Tomorrow.
So you're really early, but you already know. Some of you have seen the beach 100 times, but it's new. It's still new, even though because it's only a week ago.
It's only a week ago, and it isn't even half finished. And this is probably not even its final location. But it has been a really good playing ground, I think.
We'll also be showing this monster, which will also be in a future update.
Yeah.
But for now, we will just disappear.
Atlantis has a question, two actually. One is, will Welcome to the Jungle by Guns N' Roses be playing in this environment?
If we can get the rights, then I think some kind of karaoke version. Without any singing. Well, my girlfriend will sing over it.
Okay, so we have all three of you
as a
Welcome to the Jungle. Okay, so you've been drafted, just so you know. And, and Claire that wants to know, can I fight Axl Rose?
Fight? Or yeah. Find?
Fight.
Fight.
You fight.
You can, actually. If you know where he lives, and you have the money to get there, you can fight him.
And have
him.
A good lawyer.
Well, you don't need a lawyer to fight him.
No, but you... No, that's true.
It's quite easy to fight him.
Quite easy.
But I wouldn't recommend it. But that's quite a serious question.
Blue Dahlia has been doing some research for us. Saying, go to your dashboard. And change to playing creative hashtags in your stream title. Oh. Will help viewers find your stream.
Okay. And is it recommended to do it during a stream? Or
yeah, can we do that now or will it
crash
the system? We can try. If we crash the system, we'll start again, right?
Let's try.
It's only our ninth
stream. It's only live.
We're only live.
How many people? 500?
8 that I can
800.
See. Yeah, that's our view total.
Oh, view total. Sorry.
Yeah, 8 that I can see, but Twitch always lies to me. Twitch never tells the truth.
I'm walking with Stuffy to the area where we're going to make the jungle.
You don't want to change to the dashboard now?
What do I have to do it here? We should do it there. On your.
Oh yeah, because I'm.
Yes, it's not.
Yeah.
I'm just making a video.
Yeah, I'm heading into the dashboard. Vincent, what are you doing?
I'm walking around in the beach, on the beach, not in the beach. And the reason why I'm walking here is because there should be a thing to pick up, and then it will start from there the next time. So then we have the camera where I want to make the jungle. So let's see where it is. It's quite big. This is where the octopus was a while ago. I have to go there. So is it working?
Nah.
It's not working.
Go to dashboard, change to playing creative. Hashtags in your stream title will help viewers find your stream. So we could change the title to hashtag creative. Let's see.
This is a bit mountainy. It's quite nice, even though there's no texture. There should be, yes, there it is. And now I will pick up this thing. The eggnog. Let's pick it up. Hop.
What is it actually?
Oldie!
You've dragged the oldie tech.
And he's happy!
He's very happy about it, that's cute.
And now I'll stop.
Aw, poor Steffi.
And if I play again, we should be starting there. So now we have the empty, this will be the jungle.
Welcome to the jungle.
This is quite a big area, so we're gonna make an interesting route. Maybe we're gonna put some textures in there. Shall I start making the jungle, or shall we?
Are there more questions? No, Claudette just says that Aldi is his favorite and it reminds him of his grandpa's car.
His car looks like an old woven sweater.
His car looks
it's
like
a brown car, maybe.
Yeah, probably. Well, probably the furniture, not the car itself, but the chairs and the seats. Yeah. Okay, but tell us what you have in mind for the jungle scene. So we know that it's this is where Glitch goes to find.
Check if I can put it in the screen at the same time. I will do it like this. Yeah. I think.
So we're using the artwork we have as reference for the colors that we will use. We want to have the scene feel the same way as that picture.
So now, for instance, now it's broad daylight. I can change that with this fantastic tool where we can actually decide the time of day, the time of the longitude and the latitude, and even the Noorderlicht.
That's Northern Light.
Yeah, I don't think it's called Northern Light. It should be here somewhere.
Aurora Borealis.
Aurora. Did you see it somewhere? Or you just know it.
I knew it.
You knew it. Wow. So, I will make it night, and I will see if I can even.
Yeah, the chat says Northern Light and Aurora. Okay, hashtag creative, hashtag indie dev, hashtag game dev, hashtag. Let's go with this. Okay, so is it now saved?
I don't know how to get the moon in there. Oh, the moon is off.
The moon is off?
There was no moon.
You turned off the moon?
The moon is on.
Deliver us the moon. Please.
I have just delivered the moon, but I can't find it.
Vincent.
There is a moon somewhere.
Please try to deliver
us the
moon. I will make
a fake moon.
You may make a fake moon?
Here is a...
He's going to make a fake moon. That's not the same thing.
Look.
It's not the same thing.
It's a moon.
Claudette has some suggestions about the hashtags we could use. But I will not repeat them. I won't.
What? Are they curse words?
Jordi asks... Yeah, there are curse words. Jordi asks, will there be a space level in the woven world? Do you think there will be a space level in the world?
Jordi wants it, I think.
I think Jordi wants it. Jordi, would you like it to be... in space, this game. Would you? Well, would you?
And if so, why? Because it's all these beautiful worlds. We have the jungle, we have the desert, we have the beach, we have the meadows, and he wants space.
Let's not judge.
No, okay, let's see what answer he gives.
Let's see if he has a good answer to our question.
And maybe he can fly to, maybe Glitch can fly to the moon. How high can Glitch fly?
I think he can fly pretty high for a...
In Glitch?
For a white guy. but he probably freeze at some point.
Oh, freeze.
Claire asks a real question. Is er leven op Pluto? Kun je dansen op de maan? I think that's what your question was. What is there?
There is a place between the stars where you can go, yes. if that was the question.
For our English viewers, Clarinet quoted a Dutch song, very famous Dutch song, at least for the Dutch.
I don't know if this will look nice. I will press play. This is a fake moon. Have to be quick and dirty. Look! See the resemblance?
Oh, that's actually quite cool. It's never going to be implemented like that, but it is quite cool. Jordi says, the question is really, are the metal creatures coming from space?
Ooh, that's a good question.
And Goobal says, metal creatures from the dark side of the moon. And then Claredet says, define space. Really, I mean, what planet does Woven take place on? Well, that's actually a good question. Woven takes place on another planet in a galaxy far, far away. Are the metal creatures coming from the moon? That's a very good question. I'm not going to answer it very directly, because hey, these metal spider creatures, insects, are being very mysterious. No one knows where they're from, so I can hardly give that away in our ninth stream.
Seven. Didn't count the small one.
but it's a great theory. It's a great theory. But then, how did they get here? Are there spaceships? Yeah, I haven't seen any spaceships. So, if they,
because we haven't built them yet.
Yeah, that's also true. But also in concept art, I've never seen you concept arting a spaceship, which is actually not true.
There was a spaceship.
There was actually a spaceship in one of the earlier concepts of the game. One of the earlier concepts in which...
it was still called the Stuffies.
It was still called the
and
Stuffies.
And you had a spaceship where a mad professor worked, and he would get all the stuffed animals to his ship and rearrange the body parts. So it was a bit more freaky than now. Now you've got a very innocent-looking knitting machine that doesn't even use needles.
Yeah. It was actually a bit more of the horror that Jordi... keeps wanting for
Jordi
the game.
Wants a horror game. You've got the Five Nights at Freddy's, Jordi.
Five Nights with Freddy, Jordi. Go play that.
It's also stuffed animals.
It's a stuffed animal horror game. So, is it Jordi Lies?
Jordi Lies?
No, the ping.
So I did the general color. It's a bit more... Maybe it's
a bit turquoisey.
Yeah, but in the back here.
Yeah, and you have these grass patches that you can offset it with.
Yeah, these were meant for these kind of rocks.
Yeah.
So I will make some rocks.
So for people just jumping into the stream, we're making a brand new level from scratch. It's going to be the jungle level that you can see in one part of the screen, one with the big moon. We've just... added a moon, a fake moon, or a spaceship, as Claredet says.
In 3D it's always fake.
In 3D it's always fake. Oh, Putputty asks where the other guy is.
Where? Oh, you mean Dominic?
Yeah, so Dominic is asking where Dominic is.
Dominic is chilling and watching a movie, and apparently he's watching,
and apparently he's also watching the stream.
This movie. This is his movie.
Dominic!
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
You're just still in the stream, even though...
You're not here.
You're not here, and you wanted to watch a movie.
I have nothing to say.
In spirit.
I have nothing to
he's
say.
He's here in spirit.
Blue Dahlia wonders what skills Freddy would have.
Who's Freddy?
Freddy from Five Nights with Freddy?
I don't know. It's another game.
No, but if he was in Woven.
If Freddy, then he would be making creatures, because I think Five Nights at Freddy plays in a factory, toy factory, and it's Freddy's toy factory, so he's selling toys.
Is Freddy
He's the owner, I think, of the toy factory.
Blue Dahlia, is Freddy the owner or is he the bear with the teeth? Just let us know.
Oh. I'm just roughly making...
Claire that said a little while back, you could actually have special astronomy for the woven planet. Two glowing yarn balls or something. Like different constellations or... yeah.
That's nice. That's a good idea, actually.
Claire that says, Freddy would... Freddy would ride his bicycle. He would ride his bike. He would ride his
Freddy.
Bicycle. He would ride
that's,
it where he'd like.
That's a Queen fan. Actually, just a music fan altogether.
Yeah, Claire Dead loves his songs. That's for sure, at least.
A special skill, riding a bicycle.
Wherever he'd like. Which is always nice. So... Vincent.
What am I doing?
What are you doing, mate?
This is...
Tell me.
Look. Do you see it? I've got a bridge. Wait. That will help. A jungle bridge.
Yeah, jungle bridge.
I built it an hour ago.
Yeah, nice.
Here's a jungle bridge. It's so big. It goes up.
And then suddenly...
And then suddenly you can see...
Oh,
what
but
I'm
that is actually...
Not that far off.
That's not that far off. And we're only just starting.
Maybe a little bit bigger. Will a spider fit on this bridge?
Yes. Well, no, I don't know. What?
You don't know, right?
No, I don't know.
There's no idea if this will fit.
But I think...
I will first go there.
Yourself.
To see how big it is, roughly.
Cool.
I think it's quite big.
So, if anyone has any questions about what is going on here, just put them in chat. I'll read them to Vincent, and Vincent will answer, or I will answer, or people in chat will answer.
The moon is too high. The moon is too small.
Yeah, but you also have that, you still have mountains there.
Yeah.
Can you put a texture on the moon? Do we have like a white knitted texture? Or am I asking
this is
something stupid?
Oh, I have endless amounts of textures.
And is there something...
Knitted?
Yeah.
And white?
Yeah. Because we could do the moon snake style, but it wouldn't have the same feeling.
I don't know if I have white...
Claire that asks, why does this jungle look so much like space? Well, that's...
Because there's no trees and stuff yet.
Yeah, there will be trees. Just you wait.
I can do this one.
Is that with the buttons on it?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, it's a good starting point, I think.
I don't know if you will see it.
Because it's... This is actually far away.
There is something on there, see that?
Yeah, I can see it.
And then...
Tile?
Tile it... 9 times?
Yeah, you're the expert.
Well, there's some texture.
Yeah, I don't know if it's improved. I'm sorry.
Is Putti-Put still there?
Yeah, Putti-Put. Putti-Put!
Are you still there? You know where the moon is, maybe. In this Kentucky Fried tool that we got here. It's called
Tenkoku.
Tenkoku. Tenkoku the Kentucky
is
tool.
Is that the Kentucky tool?
Yes. We always call it Kentucky because nobody
can pronounce
Tenkoku Dynamic Sky. Mm. That's quite easy.
Google says, well, we all know the moon is made out of cheese. We don't have a cheese texture, do we?
No.
But maybe we'll make the moon out of cheese later. But yeah. I have this great idea of it being all patched up and stuff. But we'll talk about that. Jordy says, will all the concept art posted on your Kickstarter page will be for real playable levels?
Most of them so far are planned to.
Yeah.
The
no use making concept art if we don't plan to build.
Yeah,
to
but
build it.
But if you have 100, maybe you have to make a selection.
Yeah, of course it's true. There's only so much we can make, but well, we have the beach environment on there, which we of course want to make, and you have the desert part, which is already somewhat in the game. But
this is a different desert.
This is a different desert.
It's a more American desert.
Yeah, more Utah, Monument Valley kind of desert, I think. Ooh, Monument Valley shaped rocks with... yes, we should do that. So, the question is, says Claire, that do you guys have any specific things planned for this area? Well, we do.
Yeah.
Do you want to... Should I?
If you know what you want to tell.
I know. A bit.
I think it's more your area.
Well,
inspired by this, maybe.
Yeah. Well, of course, the thing is that as you see in the picture, it's just glitch. And the first concept for this level was that, at the end of the demo, Stuffy gets taken. He is maybe getting transported to another area, or while he is getting transported to another area, and Glitch will have to find him and will have to try and save him, because else Stuffy won't be good. So this is probably the level where Glitch either catches up with them, or the level where you actually find Stuffy. We don't know that for sure yet. What we do know that Glitch will have to traverse this area, and we have a planning for an encounter here. So an encounter with a dangerous creature that will get in the way and will stop to try and get Glitch.
Shall I put the spider there?
To test. Yeah.
Because it looked quite big, but the spiders are huge. Look.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's big.
He won't fit on the bridge.
Xurgle says, why doesn't the dog concept art look like an adorable basset hound?
The dog concept... Oh, the one on the Kickstarter page.
Yeah.
actually, there are... The problem with the dog is that cats are easy.
Cats are easy?
You got like three type of cats.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Like Siamese cats.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And then a general looking...
A cat.
And of course we want to do the Lopjes cat. The patched cat.
Patched
I don't know
cat.
What it's called. Lopjes cat. Anybody not Dutch? Look up Lopjes cat translation. These cats with the different patches. Because it fits the game.
Yeah,
but the dogs, there
I'm
are so
it.
Many different dogs. Looking so different. So maybe we should do more dogs.
Tortoise shell cat.
Okay.
I
like Lopjes cat more.
I like Lopjes cat as well. Claire that says calicos.
Calicos? That sounds better.
But yeah, so dogs. There are a lot of dogs. So the current dog we have is... it's just it may be one of the dogs. Maybe we could do different types of dogs in there, but first we'd probably want to expand on other types of creatures first, because well, one dog would have the sniff ability and perhaps a sort of bite or a growl, and another dog would probably have the same abilities. So but we probably could do different versions of the same species.
There could be more dogs.
Yeah, but that I think depends on how much time we have. So we first want to focus on all different kinds of animals that really will give something new to the game, and then after that, we could always expand. Yeah, always.
I don't know, I have to cheat. I have to check something. in another place, in another time, another bridge. Allow character movement. Okay.
Jordi asks, will you be able to upgrade Glitch in some way? Like putting extra bright lights on him?
Pudding.
Or something like that?
Pudding on him.
Nah, that's just my English going bad.
Putting extra
bright lights on him. Or something like that.
That sounds better.
No, it didn't. But thank you. should I answer? Should we answer?
I think there will be expansions for Glitch, at least one.
Yeah, at least one.
And probably if if we really get funky, we will make some kind of that he can be redesigned.
Yeah.
That you can customize him.
Yeah.
And so he will get some features like night vision, this kind of stuff, or sniper. So not that you will need it, but
what we want for Stuffy is to get all these different abilities through through changing. So he gets another arm, he can grab things, he gets another pair of legs that might be able to jump, he can jump. For Glitch, we don't exactly want to give him an add-on per se, but make Glitch have different abilities depending on the circumstances. That sounds vague. What I mean to say is that, for instance, he has Activate, the ability Activate. And he can activate the knitting machine, which gives Glitch the ability to knit or re-knit Stuffy. That's due to Glitch. We want to incorporate other machines, other places that Glitch can activate, giving Glitch abilities. Sometimes temporarily, sometimes maybe for a longer period. One of the functions we're actually working on is a selfie. It's a selfie function.
Selfie stick.
Like making Glitch a selfie stick. So perhaps he finds a different lens, or he finds something that makes him more than he currently is, and that gives him the ability to make pictures of you and your Stuffy, or mostly your Stuffy.
I think Glitch is a bit underestimated because people tend to focus on Stuffy.
Yeah.
And they feel like, he's the customizable character.
Yeah.
And he's the main character.
Yeah.
But actually, they're quite balanced.
Because for everything that Stuffy can't do, you have Glitch to help him, and vice versa.
And the demo is quite focused on the stuffed animal world.
Yeah.
But there will be more and more metal things during the game.
For instance, you see here that the level that Vince currently is building is mostly still yarn and wool and soft. But there is already a metal bridge there. There will be more spiders here. There's actually a sort of a beetle creature on the bridge, and as you progress, more and more metal will be there, and the focus on Glitch will be more and more so. Let's see, there's lots of questions I've sort of skipped.
Well, I have to wait because I'm baking the route that stuff it can walk on, so the computer has to calculate until this whole thing becomes blue.
Okay, well, I'll have questions for you. Claire that says, if the Kickstarter reaches 25k, Matt will talk with a British posh accent for the entire stream. Jordi says, I'll dance at 25k. Thank you, Jordi, for your input. And Xurgle will ask if I will remove the scarf. So, it's always fun to have me in the stream. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Then Blue Dahlia asks, thank you for interesting question. Well, he can technically be other patterns, right? How many patterns are currently in the game? I know I've scanned a rabbit in the game, and I've changed my character to a rabbit. So how many patterns are there currently in the game? And how many blueprints?
Currently there are 26 patterns or 27?
27. Yeah, I think. I only found 21.
And in the demo version there are only 2 patterns. Blueprints, I mean.
Yeah.
So that's the rabbit and the elephant.
Yeah.
But there's a flamingo.
Yeah, so we have already planned the flamingo.
You can see in one of the videos now.
Yeah.
One of the animated GIFs.
And we certainly have plans for a turtle or a tortoise. Plans for a dragon. Obviously the dog and the cat.
And they will have unique abilities, all of them.
So we did a quick calculation because one of these... we did an Ask Me Anything on Imgur, an image gallery, and someone asked how many variations there will be in the game, and we calculated that there would be at least
90,000?
No, 500,000. Because we plan to do at the minimum 8 characters, which each have 5 unique body parts. There are 5 slots, so that's 5 times 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 5, which is roughly 500k different possibilities. And then you of course have the textures and the fabrics that make it almost impossible to have 2 people make the same stuffy.
So you can make your own unique creature.
Yeah.
And now it's quite, the rabbit and the elephant are quite similar. But with the flamingo already, you have this weird creatures you can make.
Yeah, I particularly laughed at the one part flamingo. So it had the flamingo legs, the flamingo body, but it had an elephant head. Yeah, that was awesome.
That's quite silly.
Yeah, there was a gif of that on our Kickstarter page. So it's part flamingo, part elephant, and it looks absolutely weird, but it has
some people like it.
It has pickup with his elephant head because of the trunk, and flying because of the wings. I don't exactly know what the flamingo legs are good for, but
just
the body probably has float.
You don't want all the body parts to have a unique ability, because if they would all have a unique ability, then you will never do your favorite.
Yeah.
You will never make your favorite creature.
Yeah.
You want stomp, maybe, or you want stamp with elephant legs.
And you want different parts to have stamp, so you don't have to change.
So the rhino,
all the time.
Rhinoceros, maybe.
So rhinoceros would be very similar to the elephant character, but he probably wouldn't have pickup on his head, but he would have something like
maybe
charge or something. Push with his head instead of his paws. So that's something.
I need more bright green.
More bright green patches?
This texture's here, this is more.
Well, isn't that also due to lighting?
Yeah. That's true. But maybe I've got some other green like this.
Because you could also have these yellow patches here that also really brighten it up.
I do have these.
Yeah.
I can make this one. And with the bump carpet. Height map. Oh.
All 3Z things. Stuffy was very cute, being half flamingo and half elephant. And the legs are just very elegant. And Claire that says that if you really want to see an elegant bird, you should Google the secretary bird. Okay. That's actually a very... do you want to see it?
Yeah, sure. Okay. The secretary. I know the moonwalk bird.
Moonwalk bird?
You know the bird that can do a moonwalk? Bird. And I like hummingbirds.
So it's this bird. Should I link this?
This morning I saw a woman with a jacket with that kind of plumage.
So, I'll post the link in the chat. Another normal user says that the music is so perfect. Well, thank you.
Thank you, normal user.
We'll tell Vortigon.
Another normal user?
Yes, it's another normal user.
It's another one.
Yeah. It's not... yeah, because this is actually the music of the game that Vortigon made, the musical artist that we work with, who actually has his own SoundCloud page where he makes and shares.
He makes really cool music.
Yeah, he does great work. Okay, Jordi asks, what are you
doing?
What are you building now? Concept art to real world?
Yes, exactly that. If virtual world is real world, then exactly that.
Yeah.
So from concept art to in-game.
Yeah. So we're trying to. So we had the concept art made, or actually Vincent spent.
Look what happens to the water.
Oh, that's awesome.
I dropped my mushroom in the water and it became purple.
So it took the color. Is it why it is because of the lighting?
Look.
I think the purple water looks very cool.
Yeah, but when I press play, it's a bit overdone.
Yeah, it is.
That's because we're using Kentucky, and Kentucky can't handle multiple lights. So now it looks fine. Look, this looks okay.
Yeah.
This is actually quite cool. But sometimes... here, like this.
Oh, it's too bright!
Too much light!
Oh, I'm melting! Oh, that's awful. Yeah, that's awful. But I think, yeah, the green...
Oh, now it's purple. No, it's blue. No, it's purple. The purple looks nice.
Why is our water doing a funky chicken? This is another part of the demo level, so the water is kind of funky here.
I added the light as a moon because else it would be like this.
Yeah.
That will, and these two have lights, and it can't handle this. I can make it a little bit less dark. Even just for now, just to check what it does. Oh, this is better. Maybe this helps.
Yeah, that's better. I have to admit, it does have the feel of space at the moment.
Yeah, but it's all empty here, and there is space actually.
And there is actually space.
But the water is working better now.
Yeah, and I think the grass texture up there, it's okay.
This one.
Yeah, and in the corner. Yeah.
Everything is a bit grayish, so we need to change that.
Okay, so. We're currently making the jungle level. Vincent is brushing away, painting away. We started from scratch, and now already there's something that stuff you can walk in. I'll ask a question because I'm interested, actually.
Mm-hmm.
How do you go about the level design of such a thing? Because obviously it isn't the full level design because it's not in that stage yet.
No.
But I saw that you had you're shaping this path.
Normally, I start with roughly blocking out the area, the size. So I did that actually.
Yeah.
But now I added this river, so I have to remove it everywhere else by making the landscape like this.
Yeah.
And this I don't know yet.
Yeah, that's still rough.
And then I make some areas that I call, how do you call this, landmarks?
Yeah.
Things that your catches your eye, and in this case it's very obvious, it's this bridge.
Yeah.
So we want this shot in there. So
to
we
happen.
Want, so we want you to be standing here, seeing this.
Okay, so you've shaped, or you will shape the path leading to this point, so that the player is most likely to see...
It's exactly like this.
Okay.
So the path has to go forward.
Yeah, straight.
Not like this, not coming from this side.
Yeah.
So this could be a reason to, for instance, make a bit of hills here, so that you have to approach from that area. And then I will do, after I did the rough blocking out, I will do the sub-paths. So I will make a sort of a route, which could be interesting. In this case, it should be a bit maze kind of thing, you
okay.
know? Not too straightforward one route, but more sub-routes. And then go to these places with the camera and then add stuff until it looks nice. And that's roughly the approach.
Blue Dahlia says, I notice you are on WGN now. Will you guest host with them on Twitch?
WGN?
Yeah, WGN. Well, perhaps we will. Perhaps we won't. It's always nice to share. But as we said, we are not very accustomed to actually share Twitch streams yet, because we're all rather Twitch newbies yet. But who knows? Who knows, Blue Dahlia?
Actually, Blue Dahlia should come over and talk to us about how to Twitch.
Yeah, Blue Dahlia is probably more experienced than us.
Yeah, so we could use the tips and the suggestions.
So, blocking out an area.
Yeah, and normally I would be doing this more with more patience, because now I just want to show you the idea of how this works.
Maybe we can block out the area leading up to the bridge. Like maybe add some plants there or trees. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's possible.
Mm-hmm. I will make here an alternative route.
Ooh, alternative. I love my alternative routes.
So here's a rock. And you can go either like this or like this. And in the end, the concept art is just inspiration work, so you don't need to exactly make that concept art.
No. No, you can always derive if you think that's better.
I will make a third route. Just around here.
Xurgle asks, where's the stuffy we can adopt?
We've got two.
Yeah, we got two.
One you can adopt and one you can, well, also adopt, but...
One to love forever and one to...
Yeah.
So this is, he's here. He's always with us. He's also always close to Vincent. And being very cute and all. So there's that. Actually, the prototype we had at first didn't have a wobbly head, so his head is actually quite expressive.
Yeah, more than the other one. Yeah,
yeah.
The other one was a bit more firm.
Yeah, quite happy with that. I'll see if I can get him somewhere you can see.
Yeah, I can go this a bit down, maybe.
Up against the laptop.
Barely. You can barely see him.
So, But he's sort of watching with us. Okay. Claire that says, alternative route, climb along the trees. And then he goes yelling, tree fort, tree fort, tree fort. So.
Okay. So you want like this elven tree house thing?
Hmm.
Is that what he means?
I think, maybe a bit like the Star Wars, the Wookiee village.
What if you find a monkey?
And then you can climb.
And then you can swing from branch to branch.
Hmm, that would be cool. But would the monkey have... Because he'd have the climb abilities on his hands, mm-hmm. I think.
The swing.
And those just, yeah, the swing, and those would just grab and grab. That's cool. Zergal is saying that the stuffy plushie is lovely, but that they are limited, which is indeed true, and they've been going quite fast. We actually wanted to hand out a lot of stuffies, so we made lots of them available. But I think there are only 20 or 25 left in the early bird category to get. Oh, and we got a lot more backers since we last checked.
Did we make it to the 1800s?
Almost.
18,000, I mean?
Yeah, we're at 70,923. So that's getting very close. Yeah, we had a bit of a silent day. I think it was Monday. So Monday we did a lot of rework on the page. And today we also changed the trailer to be shorter and snappier. To more quickly convey what the game is about. That really really helped to
draw in
new people that want to pledge and support the game, which is really cool because
we need it.
Yeah,
we need the help.
Those days that are silent, in which no backer comes to us,
are scary.
Yeah, they're a bit scary.
Because how many days have we got left?
Yeah, we're at 15 days to go. And one of those 15 is almost gone. So I'd say 2 weeks. We have 2 weeks left. And I try not to think about it too much. But it's all I think and think of, actually. But, oh well. Stress, stress, stress. Stress, 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 stress. No sleep, no sleep, no sleep. But that's also part of the Kickstarter.
Yeah.
And the other part is that we've learned doing things like this, twitching, and talking with the people, with the community, which we actually didn't really do before that. Before that, we
didn't really have a product.
Well,
we didn't have presentable. Really have at least we thought we didn't.
Yeah. But now we have, and people really like it, and we're getting in. In contact with everyone that has played it and getting feedback back, which is really great. I think one of the most awesome things of this whole endeavor
is the feedback from YouTubers, from the people who are backing us.
Yeah. So Blue Dahlia says, I've tried spreading the word everywhere.
Great.
Yeah, that is great. Thanks a lot. That's you know, that's what you need, because in the end we're just three guys making this. We can shout all we want and spam our poor friends with what we're doing and try to reach new people. But in the end we're just three people. So having
we need a community.
Yeah, having people in the community that want to help us reach and grow and help grow the community. Yeah, that's awesome. It's the only way you can kickstart, I think.
Yeah.
This way. And Claire that says, and Lotje says that a monkey could pick up with its tail.
Hmm.
which is, I think, is really cool, which would probably would be the body part.
Yeah,
I think
it will be the body, and which is double cool because
there are not a lot of body parts
with skills like
with very interesting skills like that. Yeah. And then Claire that says that he can probably pick up with his monkey feet, and honestly, almost every part of a monkey could probably pick up things, which could actually be true.
But then you will have a creature that picks up
everything.
So you will still need the other body parts.
Yeah, you will. You will. But you can choose. Like you could go with, say, an elephant head, and if you'd like the legs of the rabbit, you could go with that. But you could always fill it in with a monkey part, because you could then pick up things.
Yeah.
Actually, one of the YouTubers said something about wanting to be able to pick up with lots of different body parts, which was a really good remark, because pick up is very essential.
And there is a way now that you can not pick up in the demo, which has also happened quite a few times.
Yeah, because a lot of people get the... They see the rabbit and they click on the head, so they get the rabbit head, but they don't get the rabbit arms, because they, at that point, at first in the demo, they don't realize yet that the elephant is actually the part of Stuffy giving you the ability to pick things up. So they go with...
Yeah, the head, the trunk.
Yeah, the trunk of the elephant picks things up. So they lose the pickup ability. Yeah, we actually had someone emailing us because he thought he'd found a bug. Because he couldn't pick things up anymore.
But it's a feature.
But it ended up being that he changed the rabbit head to the rabbit head.
Because we want it to be possible that you have a... you have to make choices at a certain point with puzzles. You see a puzzle, you have like five different creatures,
yeah,
and you have to make the choices. Do I want to be fast? But if I'm fast, that means I have the cheetah legs, but it means that I won't be able to jump.
Which could be possible, but you would have to have the push ability, for instance.
And you want the dragon head because he can breathe plastic, like a...
He can breathe fire.
Yeah, but that's real fire, but...
Not real
like
fire?
Like this...
Confetti.
Confetti. He can breathe confetti.
He can breathe
confetti. And then you need a new pickup. So then you will pick the monkey body. So you can still pick up. And then you need the hands. But you want the hands of a crab or something.
Yeah.
So you can... how do you call this?
Cut scissors?
Cut the spider ropes.
Yeah.
And get free.
So that's where Woven will go. You'll have all these different body parts, each with different abilities. For the most part, you will be able to just pick and choose how you would like to look, but also be mindful of abilities. And sometimes you will have to find out a certain combination. For instance, for a very tough to find fabric or item, for instance, the selfie stick that will enable Glitch to make pictures, for instance. For something like that, you would have to have to solve a very difficult puzzle, think of all the elements.
I really like the idea of the selfie stick. We actually got it working.
Yeah.
And it fits, because normally you have this mobile and you have a stick.
Yeah.
Unless you are really fancy and you have these drones, you know?
The drones that make the selfie for you.
Yeah, so you can film yourself with a drone. But Glitch is a drone.
Yeah, oh yeah.
So it's perfect to have a Glitch be able to take photos. Take snapshots of the world. And we're even planning on making a feature that you need to make a photo in the game.
Yeah.
To get past an obstacle, like a puzzle.
Yeah, so that's very cool. Another normal user.
Oh, another one.
Yeah, there's another.
Is that the new one?
It's another one.
The same another one.
It's another normal user says, "How long will the stream go? Because I'm tired."
Well, what time is it? Well, it's exactly 9 o'clock.
It's 9 o'clock. So usually we stream for an hour or so. And then we look to wrap things up and head to
Too bad.
Too bad.
Because we normally work...
Well, normally...
From, well, these Kickstarter days...
Yeah, these Kickstarter days we work at least till 10. I'm usually up till 12 with the social media feeds.
We start normal times because we've got interns.
Yeah, so we have...
And we don't want to bother the interns too much with... That have to adapt to night times and
yeah,
this kind of
so
thing.
Yeah, so this Kickstarter is very heavy for us, but we don't want to... We still need to have a normal company for the interns. So we're still here at early time. And you have to travel home for an hour or so, right?
Yeah. I will press play. Actually, I did press play.
Yeah. So we'll be probably wrapping up the stream soon. But feel free to leave any questions here or think about any questions. This is the time we can answer them. Our next stream probably won't be next Tuesday.
No, well, maybe.
Yeah,
a different stream.
Next Tuesday. We're going to be at the Indigo Festival, which is in Holland, in Utrecht.
Jabers?
Tivoli.
Oh, Tivoli. Yeah. The new Tivoli.
The new Tivoli.
Ooh, that's
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. And we have a lovely spot next to...
Deliver Us the Moon.
Next to our friends from Keoken, Deliver Us the Moon. So we're going to be with them all day. The event is from 10 to 10. So feel free to visit us there and ask us questions or meet us or shake hands or whatever. And we'll also have the demo there so you can play. But anyway, we're there till 10, so we don't know if we can... We certainly can't stream from here.
Yeah, and it's actually good that it's Tuesday. I thought it was Saturday, but it's Tuesday, and that's good because we may get some people to... help us with the Kickstarter.
Oh,
and
yeah.
We still have 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Or a little bit less. We have one...
We have 10 days.
10 days
okay.
left.
Yeah.
So it's still very useful to go there. There it is. Well, it's something. It's starting, right?
I think the moon helps.
For an hour.
I think those plants really help. I think the trees really... I think actually you did pretty good.
For 1 hour. And here... We're on the moon.
But he hasn't done the pathfinding yet.
He doesn't know how to get there. Oh, he does. We can go. Can we go on the bridge?
No.
Oh, he found a way. He found a way. Why?
How?
Why? Where is he going?
So, because the level is not yet. It's built visually, but it's not physically built.
This is too steep.
Ah, so.
Maybe this side.
Nah, yeah.
He ignores water at the moment. Oh!
Stuffy, where are you going?
Oh, it's the moon! Well, Jordi got his wish.
Oh, yeah, Jordi got his wish. Jordi, you can't complain. We've made a space level. There was a moon.
He doesn't know.
We sort of delivered the moon, but not as delivered us the moon delivered the moon. And so yeah, space level, but actually a jungle level.
It will be a jungle.
Yeah, I think the theme works very nicely, and I also think the red trees are awesome. But I love red trees. So.
And I
love
one.
This effect, yeah.
So we need to...
And then there'd be an anaconda or something, swimming around.
An anaconda?
Yeah. Or another fashion snake.
How peaceful.
No, we can have another fashion snake in there. And it'll say, ah... You are not looking mighty purple.
Oh. What? Sorry. Yeah? Continue?
No, I couldn't rhyme with purple anyway.
Nothing rhymes with purple, does it? Gerbil.
Gerbil.
But I want to show one more thing.
Okay.
Because, Jesse? Because I've got this wasp.
Yeah!
And the wasp...
He's going... In the last stream, we modeled the wasp. But Vincent actually got it to fly around and look very scary. So
Let's put it here.
I didn't thought he would show it to you, but I'm really, really excited.
I hope
that
it
he
works.
Will.
I hope it works.
Yeah, I hope too.
Because I just threw it in the jungle, and he should be going after me.
Okay.
Behind these hills.
So the wasp.
There he is!
Oh my god.
Oh.
He's stuck. Oh, it's okay.
Is he stuck?
Okay, there's nothing to worry about. The wasp is stuck, or he can't see you.
He can't see me.
Then perhaps not get too close. Oh, his eyes are glowing red.
Oh, he's stuck in another area. He's stuck.
Maybe you should help him get you.
I will throw him in this open space here. See if this helps. Oh, and we got jungle music.
How very fitting.
Will he go this way? No, not yet, but wasp attack. Oh, he's shooting. Stuff he's scared.
Yeah, I can imagine. There's a giant wasp shooting needles at him.
The reason why he wasn't walking is because I turned off his movement.
Why would you do that?
I needed the screenshot.
Oh, okay.
And he was running away. The wasp was moving everywhere. Now he's moving. Yes, there he comes.
Claire thinks the wasp looks awesome.
No!
Quickly! Quickly, before he gets you!
Hide!
Run!
Hide.
Run, Stuffy! Run!
So this is just the start of the AI of the wasp?
Oh yeah, it's very, very, very basic.
But he will circle around, trying to shoot you.
Yeah, but I think the basic animation looks really fine. And I think the idea of him shooting needles that sort of pin you.
Yeah, then you're stuck, and then I can show this badass. Where is this guy? Badass? Badass spider. Whoop, there it is. Spider in there, why not? Let's see if that one walks without flipping out. Uh-oh. I don't think it's working. Oh! They're fighting! Oh, he's stuck.
He's stuck.
He's flying.
Okay, so Jordi says, we should show the in-game and concept art looking next to each other. And we can probably end the stream after that.
Yeah, that's a good one.
So, 10 seconds for your final question while we set up the work that Vincent did and the work he did earlier. But actually I think you came quite far with this stream.
Ignore the arrow. Turn off the wasp. Turn off the spider.
How easily things are solved in Unity.
Yeah. So it's a little bit like this. Like this. I can even turn off Stuffy. Where is he? There he is. Whoops. And so we have glitch. Like this.
And then the concept art?
Whoop. A little bit.
Oh, I think more than a little bit. I think you did awesome. I think you got the colors very nicely. We can do some lighting over the water, but that's for later. But I want the moon to be either made of cheese or to have a giant patch on it.
Wool. We're making wool. Oh, that's nice.
So like a patch that covers like a quarter, like a big crater.
But then the moon is another planet to go to. Then we do need space travel.
Then if we fund by 200%, we can make a space mission or something.
Yeah.
And you'd have to go to the moon to find a missing penguin that's on the moon.
Why?
Why? Because as a wink and a nudge and a tribute to Kaoken.
Oh, I think we should, that's perfect.
An ice moon.
It's like an Easter egg.
Yeah, like an Easter
egg. You can find
the penguin on the moon. And he's there very lonely, he's very sad, and living alone, waiting for Stuffy to save him. So now everybody thinks that the penguin needs saving, but that's okay. Okay.
So let's wrap it up.
Let's see if there are more questions. No? Well, Jordy says, great stream, guys. Well, we want to say...
Thanks, Jordy.
And
thanks, everybody, for watching.
Yeah. And for asking the questions and talking with us and being here with us and sharing this part of the Kickstarter madness with us in this developments stream. And I think that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See you maybe Tuesday.
Yeah, so maybe...
In a different way.
Maybe Tuesday we're going to live stream at Indiegogo. But we have to make sure that's possible, technical-wise. So, else we'll be here Thursday.
Yeah.
So that's a week from now. By that time we'll have one more week left to get Woven funded. To get... Stuffy funded. So I'll pray to the gods.
We're
I'll pray
praying.
To all of them.
Yeah.
And I will. I actually will. Okay. Thank you. I'll see you next time.
Bye bye.
Goodbye, y'all.
Bye. Bye bye.